Welcome back to another episode. Today we are working on this dining room. Going to get a textured light orange peel to match the other rooms. This wall used to have wallpaper in it, so we scraped it all off, had a couple gashes in the drywall. So we skim coated it. Once we skim coated, we did a Kills primer to seal everything. And now we're ready for texture. I'm gonna get everything painter's plastic on everything here. And then I'll get the mud mixed up, get the gun out, and we'll lay down some texture. The first thing I gotta do is, you know, corral all the tools and get this taped off a little more. I'm missing the baseboard over here, and then getting the windows taped off and a little bit of the ceiling. I think I'm gonna use my shield for the ceiling. The ceiling's orange peel. Don't ask why I'm not doing that. I mean, you can, but it's only orange peel really in the house. Didn't really want to mess with it. It is a little outdated, but it's not bad. Maybe later on we'll think about doing something different, but for now, that's what they want. Light orange peel on the walls, down the road. Can always do knock down the ceiling, but for now, we're just worried about this because it's been sitting like this for a while. So I'm gonna go to the tools corral, get this taped off, and get this thing textured. Let's jump right into it. All right, so we got all the floor taped off, the windows. I have two doors left to do. I am waiting on doing this main door that you're seeing me through. It's my main access to the basement. I still need to go get a bucket of mud, a clean bucket, because I'm going to mix it into that since we're watering it down. I'm using all-purpose green lid mud. It has a better adhesion, and that's usually what I do. The blue is more of a finishing coat. So to do that, I just need to tape this entrance off into the kitchen. I'll bring everything in. We'll tape this one off. Mix the mud up. I'm gonna do 4.5 gallons, which has the size of a mud bucket. I think that's gonna be plenty for this room. And the reason I said 4.5, usually you wanna do a bigger batch because you adjust the gun on the mudding gun. It has an air and a flow control. Well, if you're mixing multiple batches, it's always gonna be different and you're gonna be there test spraying to get your texture. So I like to do a little bit bigger batch. It doesn't go to waste. I know I have more texturing to do here soon, so I'm gonna use that for the other areas. Don't do like a crazy amount. You kind of just get an eye for it as you go. So with the bucket of it, I'm gonna do more. I'm just going to the higher scale of that. If I need to use it for this other patch area I have, I'll use it over there. But that ensures that it's the same consistency. I'm sitting at the gun once and then I'm just worried about spraying. So let's go get the air compressor, mud, start mixing mud, and then we'll start spraying. So what I'm doing here, is I am just touching up a couple spots. Everything that I need is taped off. We went around, we double checked the walls. Everything looks really good. You can see a little wet spot there at a touch up. That's gonna be fine. It is drying by the time I mix the other mud. Not preferred, and there's a little touch up there. There used to be a window here. Can't even tell anymore. Everything's really flat there. Got all the outlets covered. We're gonna mix up this bucket of mud. It's a weird consistency. It's not like, it's a little wetter than peanut butter. Say almost kind of like syrup. You kind of want it, if you put it on a hawk, if you kind of tilt it, it's gonna go down. It's not gonna just slide right off. I'll try to show you the consistency once I get it mixed up. But we're gonna start mixing that, getting that to what I need to, and then I'll put it in the gun, get the air compressor running, and we're gonna start laying down texture. All right, so what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna have a thing full of water. I'll use just a little small trash can, and then I'm pouring water into the bucket. Oh, this isn't a new bucket. It was like 3/4 of the way full. Forgot I had it. So totally 4.5 gallons. I'm probably like 3 gallons of mud. I'm pouring water in until it looks like a yogurt consistency. You go a little bit less than that, but I usually shoot for just a yogurt consistency, and it'll spray pretty good, and you'll kind of get used to it. So we're gonna mix this up, get a nice yogurt consistency, and then we're going to hook our gun up. This one's from Marshalltown Sharpshooter 1. Use it for everything. It is really good. I'll leave a link below where you can get it. Multiple adjustments on it, and then it has a hopper. This is, I'd say, commercial grade. They have some where you have a hopper on the floor and it shoots into your gun, but this works fine. What we're gonna do though is mix the mud. We'll hook the gun up, let the air compressor run, and then I'm gonna get some cardboard or a different colored paper, put on the wall so I can see what I'm getting for a texture before I spray it on the wall. We're gonna do that, and I'll show you each step. I'm gonna run the air compressor at like 40 to 50 PSI, and I'm going to leave this ball valve here just all the way open. Really, you want your spray guns to have this ball valve on it. It just makes it easier, because otherwise you just have air constantly come out of here. You can get splatter on your wall. So when you're done spraying a wall, just shut that. Nothing's gonna come out, but that is definitely a good add-on. Some of them don't come with that. I think most Marshalltown ones do, and once you start doing it, you're gonna notice that it's kind of a necessity to have. But let's get this mud mixed, and I'll get everything else set up. What we're gonna do, this texture, preferably use brown or red paper. I don't have any here, so I'm just gonna use plastic. It's not the best, but it'll work. Really, you just are testing your texture and making sure you like the pattern. That'll hold up. So what we're gonna do, kind of gets loud in here. I have the hopper filled up, air compressor's running, I have it at 50, I have the ball valve cracked a little bit, so I'm running around 45 PSI. I have the gun adjusted to the smallest nozzles, so I'm going for a light orange peel. We're gonna do a couple passes on here to verify that I like the texture, pull this off, and we're gonna start from the top and go down, and we're just gonna circle around the room. Textured. I had issues with my phone dying, but after you guys saw me run the spray gun, I finished out everything. I don't know if you can really
tell. But it's a nice orange peel. Now that spot's just there. It's just a different color that I missed with the paint. But it looks really good. It's going to match. It actually matches the mudroom really well. You're not gonna be able to really tell probably. But yep, whole thing's done. Get paint on there tomorrow. This room will be finished, except from the can lights. Then you go through the kitchen, do LVT, paint the cabinets white, can lights in the kitchen. But that turned out really good. That's a lot better results than I've had in the past. Just, you know, focusing. Oh, I did actually have my PSI drop on the air compressor on this wall, and it got thick. So I put the gun down, I scraped everything off with a knife, and did it again. Because you want to do it right, make sure everything looks good. And it's honestly, I'm very happy with this. It is awesome, really consistent. When I paint it, it's gonna look great. I didn't mud any of the long seams of when this addition was put on. They didn't do a very good at mudding this seam. It's relatively flat, but it just didn't do very many layers. So there's a 2-foot section that I think I'm gonna be able to see with the paint. I'm gonna just wing it. I'm just gonna paint it and see how it looks. I can see it right now. So I'm guessing I'm gonna see it with the paint, but I do not wanna have to mud that. I wanna get this painted. I don't see it being an issue, but that's the only spot I noticed. Everything else is perfect, spot on. I appreciate you guys watching this video. There'll be more to come. We'll start posting some more. Just been really busy. So thank you again, and I'll see you in the next one.